Who knew that fire in a forest could actually be a good thing? But that's only the case if it is properly managed, and that takes someone who is certified and trained to light fires right.
Each burn of ours, we have a specific objectives that we're trying to reach, and after we do our burn, we always come back out and evaluate our burn to decide whether or not we did reach our goals and our objectives. And if we didn't, then we know how to tweak the weather parameters on the next prescription, on the next burn, so that we do make our goals and objectives.
Is there any way that we could see a burn or fire today?
Yeah, we're gonna do a burn today.
That's fantastic, I'm ready.
All right, well, there's a few things we need to take care of before we get started. First of all, just so you understand, us in the fire profession do a lot of training so that we understand exactly what it is that we're doing. We understand how to write prescriptions, which has to do with where we're burning, what we're burning, why we're burning it, our objectives, etc. Things like safety issues and how are we going to manage our fire if the fire does get out.
That's good to know. And then after that, you get a cool outfit like this, huh?
Yes, this is our PPE, or our personal protective equipment. I've actually got some set out for you now. And these clothes right here are made out of Nomex, which is a fire-resistant clothing. It's also very breathable, so it helps us to not get too hot. And of course, we need a radio harness so that we can keep in communication to make sure that we're safe as we're out here on the burn. Always need a good pair of gloves. Leather is our glove of choice. And of course, we need a hard hat so we make sure we protect our noggin.
Perfect.
All right.
I'm ready.
After you, let's go.
Is this what we're gonna burn?
We're gonna burn this unit right in here. And the main reason why is that the grasses are starting to accumulate from the last 2 years of not being burnt. And so it's starting to get too thick for a little bobwhite quail, et cetera, to go through there. The other thing that was really important to the animals that we manage for is the ground cover. And that ground cover is the grasses and the weeds. And so if you get too much shade, these vegetation, it won't grow very well. We need to top kill some of these volunteer pines. That'll help open up the sun to get to the ground.
That's so interesting, because to me it almost looks like a regular forest.
Looks like a very well managed forest, I would agree.
Well, let's burn it.
All right.
I see some of the little baby trees are still alive even with the fire.
Yeah, fires, they kill very little. What they do is it's what we call top kill, and it kills the part of the plant that's above ground. But the roots are still intact. And as soon as it rains again, all of these grasses that are now black will sprout out with fresh growth. And that fresh growth is very high in nutrients, nutritional value. So herbivores like deer will come in here very quickly after a burn and after it starts to resprout. And those are the shoots that it wants to eat. It is a vital part of the Southeast ecosystem. Prescribed burning and frequent fire is a must if we're going to maintain the biodiversity in the plant life and the biodiversity in the animal life.
And it's so controlled, it's only right where I set it.
You light the fires under the weather conditions that we can handle and that we can manage, and makes fire much easier, and you only get the benefits instead of the negatives. There you go. Your first lit prescribed fire.